Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that putting off our old self with all its ways, we may live as Christ did, for through the healing paschal mysteries, you have conformed us to his nature, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Stephen, filled with grace and power, was working great wonders and signs among the people. Certain members of the so-called synagogue of freedmen, Cyrenians and Alexandrians, and people from Cilicia and Asia, came forward and debated with Stephen. But they could not withstand the wisdom and the spirit with which he spoke. Then they instigated some men to say, "We have heard him speaking blasphemous words against Moses and God." They stirred up the people. The elders and the scribes accosted him, seized him, and brought him before the Sanhedrin. They presented false witnesses who testified, "This man never stopped saying things against this holy place and the law. For we have heard him claim that this Jesus, the Nazarene, will destroy this place and change the customs that Moses handed down to us." All those who sat in the Sanhedrin looked intently at him and saw that his face was like the face of an angel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. Though princes meet and talk against me, your servant meditates on your statutes. Yes, your decrees are my delight. They are my counselors. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. I declared my ways, and you answered me. Teach me your statutes. Make me understand the way of your precepts, and I will meditate on your wondrous deeds. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. Remove from me the way of falsehood. Favor me with your law. The way of truth I have chosen. I have set your ordinances before me. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you.
After Jesus had fed the 5,000, his disciples saw and that Jesus has not gone on with his disciples of the boat, but only his disciples left. Other boats came from Tiberias, near the place where they had eaten the bread, when the Lord gave thanks. When the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they themselves got into boats and came to Capernaum looking for Jesus. When they found him across the sea, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you get here?" And Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say you are looking for me, not because you saw signs, but because you ate the loaves that were filled. Do not work for food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For on him the Father God has set his seal." So they said to him, "What can we do to accomplish the works of God?" And Jesus answered and said to them, "This is the work of God, that you believe in the one who he sent, the gospel of the Lord."
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Work for food that lasts for eternal life. Some people on a weight producing program were discussing the reasons why they overeat. One person said, "I overeat whenever I get bored or depressed. I don't know why, I just have the refrigerator at those times, but that's just what I do." Another person said, "I think it's because you're hungry when you go eat, but it's probably more of a spiritual hunger. Your mistake is trying to satisfy a spiritual hunger with physical food." In today's reading, Jesus alludes to the fact that we have two lives to nourish, one physical life and, of course, our spiritual life. One requires physical food, the other requires spiritual food. Today's reading invites us to ask ourselves, have we ever caught ourselves trying to fill a spiritual emptiness with material things? We're asked to reflect, as Isaiah said, "Why spend money on what does not satisfy? Why spend your wages and still be hungry? Listen to me and do what I say, and you will enjoy the best food of all." May God bless you. Let us pause now to offer our petitions to our Father.
This Mass is offered for the repose of the souls of Joel McLeverton and Henry Vanel Fugon. For these intentions, let us continue to pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis, may God continue to give him the courage and strength necessary for effectively leading our Church. Let us pray to the Lord. For government leaders, may the promptings of the Holy Spirit guide them in working to protect the sanctity of human life from conception through natural death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen ill and those who have died from the coronavirus pandemic, as well as those charged with protecting the health and safety of others, and those tending to the sick and seeking a cure, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all unborn children, that our love for them may keep them safe until the joyous day of their birth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our men and women in uniform, Lord, protect them in their time of need and sustain their families in these uncertain times. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the full recovery of a Sterling Court resident who tested positive for COVID-19 and that the virus not spread further within the Sterling Court community, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faithful departed, including Patrick Gibbons, for whom Our Lady of Grace candle burns this week, may he, through Our Lady's faithful intercession, now rejoice with the angels and saints for all eternity in God's heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those petitions we hold within the silence of our hearts. For these, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For ceasing working, we also include in this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to abortion and euthanasia throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty Father, we ask you to hear the prayers which we bring before you humbly, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness, we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble confidence, we will be accepted by the sacrifice of your son, this day. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all holy churches.
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that, purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, that loved you more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and never and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb not slain, who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope, with Oscar, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever."
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your word, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life and the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of the saving food, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.